Scoobascope is sponsored by
Why does today feel like my Friday officially? I don't even know. Yesterday I had zero energy. Today I'm on cloud 10,000 with this energy, and it's a Tuesday, people. It's a Tuesday. I wanted to say something. So I was having a conversation with someone, and we're trying to understand what terms does a man use to evaluate a girl, whether she's potential, whether she's white material. I'm like, what would you first look at her and just say that's the what? And the argument is still going strong, so please hit me up in the comment section, men especially. Let me know, when you bump into a chick, what's the first thing you look at that gives you an impression of what she is? Do you wait for her to open her mouth? Do you just look at how she ensembles herself, how she dresses up? Or do you look at her walk, or if she bites her nails? Just hit me up, because I need to win certain bets. It's January, okay? On that note, this show is proudly sponsored by Fanta Baby, and welcome. So I'm going through a blog, just trying to get my facts and stories together, because I have stories that are brought to me, and then I'll decide if we can make do with them or not. And a story about apparently Wyke Bender is expecting his second baby only 6 months after the last. I was like, come, son. At least your female... Josephine, what had I called them? He has man boobs. For a guy with that much lipstick and man boobs and a funny girly body, kudos, the macho man in you is showing. So he has officially joined the likes of Wizo, of Ready and Wizo. He has officially joined Future. Why am I saying this? Two different baby mamas, and that, you know, the count could keep going high. I was just saying. So now that you have two baby mamas up front, I hope we are going. How many do you think we should go for? On average, how many baby mamas do you think Wyke Bender should have? You could actually be like Diamond Platnumz, his father Abraham. He has a child everywhere in East Africa. I just want to understand, though. I want to understand what's wrong with our artists. I know Omsaja Enoch Sajalat, and it's not just our artists here. I would be remiss if I only put it on ours here. Just globally, what is so hard about you siring your oats in one human? One! Just one. When they broke Wyke's heart, they broke everything. It is just going around. Anyway, I just wanted to remind everyone, use protection. AIDS is real. Kongs, Wyke. I was actually going to go lightly on Wyke Bender. Then I remembered the rumors that were part of the circulation with his very first child. Of course, when we saw that news, we were all like, woo-loo-loo, woo-loo-loo, Kongs, Wyke Bender, some chick just, you know, broke your heart, you were ready to get married, now you're having a baby. Then, for all of you who didn't know, actually, that baby, he keeps putting the baby on Instagram all the time, eh? With sweet captions and everything. But Wyke, we all know from the jump you had jammed that child, don't we? Come to Alakumsai. Did you first do a DNA like as though you didn't know what you were dipping your caustic into? So you think that some woman got up and she's like, I'm expecting your baby. Do we look like Justed? Or is Justed us? Are we him? Is him us? Is we him? Is us we? You get what I'm saying? So, binobe muja ku Facebook, Instagram, ne mutijiso wana wa mwengate in the background, we know your deadbeat fathers who just need the law to first set you on course. Katulinda naona agenda mutijisa na yechirunji musaigo. Kongs. No! Like, seriously, someone was like, T, why are you giving that ka Kongs with a pinch of salt? Yo, the Single Mothers Association is alive and well. We at times have to be very wary of them. The single mothers of this country are all like the chicks on Mama Ten. You go after one and it's a wrap. They're like Me Too in America. You get where my loyalties have to lie. I'm not forgetting I have two dead baby fathers myself, so. love this world. Anyway, Kongs. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, nganange sima incha bikole. Already, Leila Kayondo's musical career is non-existent. Why she still keeps investing in it? Well, I'll tell you, sometimes stupidity is also sexually transmitted. In this case, I don't know who transmitted stupidity to this one. Anyway, a story came out. Some guy is claiming that Leila asked for 1 million Uganda shillings. Uganda, mbuyamgamba genda kujayo in a video, the most recent useless thing, the one with chameleon that I talked about. Nyumirwa. Mbuyamalo zimwa, Leila na jakama simu. Then the blog goes ahead to say that according to inside sources, it seems Leila tasobola first of all kukula just 1 million. Like she wouldn't just ask for 1 million. She's one of them. That's according to the inside sources. And then they go ahead to say that perhaps someone could have gotten Leila's number and they're using that same number to like fleece people off. I'm like, okay, that makes sense. But I need for you people to educate me. There's people in the studio. So say my phone that is registered in my name, you send money to it, right? For me to withdraw that money, I need to have my own personal passcode, right? So abafere baina backdoor eyoku beating other withdraw process. You take where I'm going with this, because that's the allegation. They say they're like, probably someone is using that line to fleece people off. And I've seen people say that most times, like, oh, disregard anyone telling you to send money or anything. Even the ones that bafere who tell you to send money, that I'm probably stuck here or that and I'm so and so, they give you an alternative number. But according to the screenshots that are on this particular blog, the money was directly sent to Leila's phone. And then they go ahead and they say stuff like, Leila changes her number every time. Let me ask, Leila, why would you change your number every time? I have held the same number for the past 5 years, and my job is not the fanciest. One number. So, maybe if the hoeing industry is actually that hard, then I can understand. Someone try to give me the basics here. I send money to a number, it brings the name that I have sent it to. So how does someone fleece me? Because at the end of the day, for me to withdraw it into liquid cash, I need to have a passcode. Oh, I know. That's the allegation. Na eba na ina mwabasaji ya temuko wa kuba kuba kumitwe. Abana baba kudde kuva 19 kankweso, okay. Mpaka kati bachaba kula. I swear baba musajja mweno industry mweno time mukana akasera mugwangali. Ngaba chakukula njagala otule in a very quiet place and be honest with yourself. I know it will be painful, but tell yourself, God, I'm stupid. Forgive me. Like, come on. In an era where girls are just walking up to guys and asking for threesomes, in an era where a girl will tell you, if you buy me OTT for a month, I'll let you hit it. I mean, bachaba kula. But then I also understand that women have not yet got there with jobs to get some kamani, so let's move on from there. Anyway, the rumor, the story was what? Video allegations apparently are not right. They are false. But then again, you could look at it in another way. They are trying to push the song. You know, Ugandans, temukowa kulowoza ngaba kopi. Someone could have actually told Agendo tunde chino chistore kweno blog. Abantu bachitamze, olimba lutambule. No. Your stupidity will go around. Your talent won't. Or should I say, lack thereof. Talent won't. I know. Ndiyebio. Nemo manyo. Doza kanzi kilize. Fale mitumese sobula butoge lako. Kwa mbela njagala bido jinga mbibuke ko then nebi mkuba mu face. Because I just can't help it. Did you watch that interview or listened to that interview that Rema did recently, and she was all there telling us how she has Eddie Kenzo's land titles and how he trusts her and how they're safe with her and how they're still best friends and they share a baby together. I'm like, okay, first of all, TMI, none of our business. We don't really care. Secondly, am I the only one who is missing something in this loop? I mean, not to be a conspiracy theorist, but am I the only one who doesn't... something just doesn't add up here. So you keep all these... He says they're best friends. On the other end, Eddie Kenzo is crying to see his best friend and his child. Which is which? Are you friends? Are you frenemies? Are we applying the enemy of my enemy is my closest friend theory? Which is which? I see, like the old adage goes, the higher monkey goes, the more it exposes its behind. Tubalinze. We are going to keep adding up above ones, twos, three, because at first we were happy for you. Now you just decided to do it for showbiz. So let us also just comment for showbiz to Chidimukati. And another thing I wanted to ask, if Yon and Kenzo are still as good as bosom buddies, if Ngawe Mogahamba, still, certain things don't add up. Do they add up for you, Ranel? Take the big water gun. 1 minute we're bosom buddies. Next minute, Sheikh Musata says again, though, I said, Kenzo is crying, where are you? Next minute, they are doing a kwanjula and all these wukodios and throwing on social media just to say, omwavu wakufa government, where are you? Because, I mean, if you ask me, that's the only reason they post up all the things that happen in their lives. They are trying to taunt somebody. Question is, who are you taunting? Because if this was just a relationship between you and Hamza and how you love each other, let me tell you something about when you connect with a soulmate in a way you don't even want nobody to share that ish. Like you feel, just people knowing how much and how good your love is might rob you of it. I know there are people who will relate to this. So, because you were social media, bwachi. Bwina gwabunonoza. Over it is just for the fact that, well, she's a recording artist and she could use the vibe. Because it keeps people talking, which means she gets more bookings. Either way, all logic put to side, I am glad they are still best friend, like Eddie Kenzo says, or a best friend wange. Kudos, pass and go to Vewano. Before I can go, I remember last year there was an issue about dummy. The word dummy and dummy artist. It was going on between who knew it was Ntale and it was Cindy and Shiba when they had that weird Vink and Enibam Sikam. They pulled in so many people, who is a dummy artist and who is a real artist. So someone asked that between these three categories, so we have a dummy, a talented one, and a gambler. Please, T, put these three people of Swang's Avenue according. And then they gave me, that's Irene Ntale, and then they gave me Winnie Nwaji, and then they gave me Vinka. Now I have to give all of those guys what I believe. One, Irene Ntale, for me, will always go under talent. Because with or without much, she's still talent. She sounds good, she writes good, she plays an instrument. That's talent. Now, if you ask me about Winnie, I'm also going to put Winnie under talent. Because despite her stupidity, shenanigans and all of that, that girl can bloody sing. If you give her a minute to sing without the acoustics and everything, just her, there's something there you can harness, you can grow. If you ask me, Vinka, yes, she's the one who is doing good. She has Sony and all of that. And you need to understand, Sony can waste that much amount of time and put it on a gambler. Because you see, the thing about a gambler is at times you win, at times you lose. But either way, there's a gamble going on. That is Vinka for me. It doesn't mean that she's not talented. It doesn't mean that we do not respect her as an artist. I'm just saying, if you ask me professionally, that is where I'd place them. I would say Irene and Winnie go under talent, and Vinka would go under Gambo. And if you ask me, Gambo is not bad. You know why Gambo is not bad? Because Gambo is something that the industry is going with. Can you fit here? Can we fit you here? Can we fit you there? Well, now we're back to Tida or fitting. Oh, that's why I say Vinka's career shut off real quick because she was open. Now, when it comes to talent, talent is harder to manage. Talent is harder to harness because the fact that they know they have the talent, they slack. And then they take everything for granted. So if you ask me, all three parties, win-win situation. That's my professional take anyway. On that note, at TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop under TinaFierce1. Not forgetting on Instagram we are Scoop and what are we on Instagram? On Instagram, it's a TinaFierce1 with an H. And on Snapchat, we are TinaFierce1. I'll catch you on the flip side, which is tomorrow. Go and look for something annoying that I can crush on. Yeah. I'm out. Peace.
Scoop on Scoop was sponsored by